Right, let's expand on this conversation. Managing Director of VOL Air Logistics, Nozipho Mbatha, joins us to expand. Nozipho, very good evening to you. Thank you for your time. Things are looking up. I mean, just listening to what some of those attending that conference have said, and also just gauging on the current dynamics in the aviation industry. But we do know that it's a sector that faces significant hurdles in its recovery in the wake of the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. What challenges do you think are most important for the industry to overcome with, you know, looking forward and building up and ensuring that they make up for the lost years?
Good evening. Good evening, Paul, and good evening to the viewers. Thank you for having me. Actually listening to your speakers from the conference earlier, the challenge we have as a country and a continent is that we are always we have a government, firstly, that is not intentional in its endeavors. And then we always move with the developed economies without being cognizant of our reality. Therefore, our solutions are not really custom made for us. So having said that, I was listening to one of the speakers speaking about the introduction of the drones in the aviation space and so forth. We have the state-of-the-art facility, Dube Trade Port in KwaZulu-Natal, that is not being used to its capacity. Government has invested in that good quality, secured, modern infrastructure. But because we haven't, as an industry, leveraged the power and the enabling ability of the aviation industry in terms of moving cargo, we're gonna have such facilities lying fallow. So actually one of the speakers at the conference, Mr. Ellis, the marketing director from Airbus, said something which I hope the conference, the African leaders that are at the conference and the business leaders there must actually take to heart and work on that. Because he said the critical role of air transport as the socio-economic driver, as it moves the goods, it moves the people, it moves investments. So we are coming from COVID-19, which was the aviation was the hardest hit during the pandemic. But also that crisis taught us something: the efficient movement of goods through air transportation. If you wanna talk about the free trade in Africa, we don't have the necessary infrastructure to leverage that enabling environment except through air. But what are we doing about that? Even if you're gonna say South Africa is a gateway, we have ports that are the efficiency with ports. You have industries closing down because our ports are not efficient. Why are we not moving the light industry goods to air, you know? So and with these challenges now that we are experiencing, the deteriorating infrastructure of the airport, because obviously the pandemic slowed down the use, therefore there's not much income that is generated there. If that's part of the solution to start driving hard cargo, increase that demand of movement of goods through air transport so that you can start having AXA generating income to improve the infrastructure and therefore bring back the efficiency. So for me, I think it's important to actually make sure that our leaders and the business leaders that are attending this conference doesn't miss this critical point that was spoken of by Mr. Ellis, of using air transport as an enabler, as a socio-economic enabler. How do we do that? Maybe that's what the next conference should discuss, the next African Aviation Transport, that how should discuss how can we leverage air transport to enable growth in our economy as the continent and obviously as the country.
I think one of the questions would be around you know, you speak about solutions that are not custom made, but how can available opportunities be maximized in Africa? Because for one, collaboration would be a big part of it in ensuring that there is infrastructure development.
Definitely, collaboration is imperative, especially between business leaders, among business leaders within the region, and amongst leaders in business and in government, right? So that's what I'm saying, that the challenge is that when government is not intentional, right now, we're going to see our government running to invest in the infrastructure that they are seeing happening in the developed economies without engaging business around their needs. What do we need as businesses in the aviation space to ensure that we can best serve our clients more efficiently? There, you're speaking about the involvement of SARS, customs. You're speaking about the involvement of police for safety. There's a whole lot of departments that get involved, but if the Minister of Transport is moving in silos to say, oh, this is the direction now that the aviation industry is taking, I must push for that investment without engaging the business, that's going to ensure that she understands what are the imperatives that we require, so that whatever government invests in, we can then hop in that, because that's their role. Provide the infrastructure that we need as business so that we can provide a better goods and services. Government doesn't provide goods and services. So hence, I'm talking about this custom-made solutions. We are a developing region. We are a developing country. So when these solutions come, like I'm telling you now that you have a facility, Dube Trade Port facility in Durban, it's the closest to the modern facilities of air cargo, but it's not used. It's not used as much as your Cape Town and as your Joburg. Why not? Why is government not opening routes, the Department of Transport opening routes in the region where the Durban port, when we receive goods through the Durban ports, King Shaka can distribute these goods into the region, things like that. Or like I'm saying, moving the light industries from the port into air. So definitely collaboration is necessary in that regard, that we have to find a way where we are engaging and directing our leaders in government, because they are the ones who drive the investment towards infrastructure, even though they work with private investors. Yeah. But the policy that drives those investment is solely led by government.
Very well. Thank you so much for weighing in on this conversation. Nozipho Mbatha, VOL Air Logistics Managing Director, expanding on the aviation conversation that was underway in Sandton.